Hello friends, in this video I am going to explain about the system of circles. From this chapter we will get total 6 marks, so that is a 2 plus 4 equals to 6 marks. So first of all we have to learn about what is the basic concepts about this chapter. So I am taking here two circles, S equals 0 and S dash equals to 0. This is S equals to 0 and this is S dash equals to 0, that both are intersecting at point P. These both are intersecting at point P. Then the angle between the tangents of two circles at P, the angle between these two are tangents. So this is a one tangent and this is a second tangent. These both are intersecting at point P. So the angle is making at P. This is a theta. This is a point P. So this theta, this angle made by the tangents, this angle is only called angle between the circles. The angle between the tangent is only called angle between the circles. So we call tangents of two circles at P is called angle between the circles at P. Okay, understood? Okay, that I'm taking circle. First circle, S equals to x square plus y square plus 2g1x plus 2f1y plus c1 equals to 0. And S dash, second circle, I'm taking x square plus y square plus 2g2x plus 2f2y plus c2 equals 0. When the angle between the two circles is theta, then the angle cos theta equals to d square is nothing but a distance between the two circles. This is the first circle center and this is the second circle. The distance between these two circles is d. So d square minus r1 square minus r2 square. r1 square is nothing but first circle radius. This is the first circle radius and this is the second circle radius. r1 square minus r2 square by 2 into R1, R2. This is the angle between the circles. This angle is we call D square minus R1 square minus R2 square by 2 R1, R2. And also we can show, if you don't know about the R1 and R2, that means radius of the first circle and the radius of the second circle, if you don't know, only the given equation, we can follow this formula also. C1 plus C2 minus 2 into G1, G2 plus F1, F2 by 2 into R1 square. This is R2 square. R1 and R2. Radius of the first circle and radius of the second circle. And next, what about if theta is 90 degrees? If theta is 90 degrees, the angle between the two circles is 90 degrees. It is a 90 degrees. What about if it is 90 degrees? What happens? That time we call these two circles are intersected orthogonally. So orthogonal means if you substitute here cos 90, we know cos 90 equals 0. So that means if it is a become 0, so when it is sent to the right left side, it becomes something into 0 is a 0. So completely it is become 0. Then we'll get only this term. C1 plus C2 minus 2 into G1 plus G2 plus C1 F1 into F2. That we can get. So finally, so when theta equals 90, that we call orthogonally intersected. Then the formula will become C1 plus C2. C1 plus C2 equals to 2 times G1 G2 plus F1, F2. This is a formula when the both circles are intersected with 90 degrees. That is only we call orthogonally intersected. Okay. Next term. When two circles are having the common tangent. To find this equation, if I take it is a S equals to 0 and it is a S dash equals to 0. To find the equation of common tangent, that is s minus s dash equals 0. This is a common tangent equation, and we call this is a radical axis. We call this is radical axis. To find this equation also, this is s equals 0 and this is s dash equals to 0. Again, this is also same formula, s minus s dash equals to 0. And same for this is we call common chord, and its equation also s minus s dash equals to 0. To find the this equation, s minus s dash equals 0, radical axis for also same formula. We'll use the same formula to find the common tangent, radical axis and common chord. Okay, based on these formulas, we have some questions. Let's see. First question, find the angle between the circles. x square plus y square minus 12x minus 6y plus 41 equals to 0. And the second one, x square plus y square plus 4x plus 6y minus 59 equals to 0. Okay, from this formula, we have a formula. So what the formula? Cos theta is equals to C1 plus C2 minus minus 2 into G1, G2 plus F1, F2 by 2 into root over G1 square plus F1 square plus minus C1 under root G2 square plus F2 square minus C2. Okay, first of all, we have to write what is the all here. Okay, G1 equals to minus 6, F1 equals to minus 3, and C1 equals to 41. Similarly, G2 equals to 2, F2 equals to 3, and C2 equals to minus 59. These values we have to substitute in the given formula. Cos theta equals to C1 equals to 41 minus C2 is a 59 minus 2 into G1 equals, we got here, minus 6 into G2 is a 2 plus F2 is a minus 3, F1 is a minus 3, F2 is a plus 3 by 2 into root over G1 square. That means minus 6 whole square plus minus 3 whole square minus 41 the root over G2 square. That means 2 square plus 3 square minus of minus plus 59. Next, cos theta equals to 41 minus 59. That is minus 18. Minus 2 of minus 12 minus 9 by 2 into root over 6 square is 36 plus 9 minus 41 2 square 4 plus 9 plus 59. You're getting this? Cos theta equals to minus 18 and this become minus 21. Minus 21 2s are plus 42 by 2 into root over, this become 45. 45 minus 41 is a 5. Sorry, 4. And this become 68. 72 cos theta equals to 42 minus 18. And it can be written as 36 2s, 2 1s, 2 12s, 2 1s, 2 6s. Cos theta equals to 6 by 6 into root 2, 6, 6 gets cancelled, cos theta equals to 1 by root 2, in cos table we'll get at cos theta equals to cos 45 degrees, here cos gets cancelled, theta equals to 45 degrees, like we can find angle between the two circles. Next, show that the circles x square plus y square plus 4x plus minus 2y minus 11 equals 0 and x square plus y square minus 4x minus 8y plus 11 equals 0 intersected orthogonally. Intersected orthogonal means we have to show that c1 plus c2 equals to 2 times g1 g2 plus f1 f2. This we have to show. Both LHS and RHS should be equals. We have to show that. Here, first of all, we have to write what is G1, F1, C1, and G2, F2, C2. So here, G1 equals to 2, we can get F1 equals to minus 1, C1 equals to minus 11. G2 equals, we can get minus 2, F2 equals, we can get minus 4, and C2 equals, we can get 11. These values we have to substitute here. If you get both equals, LHS and RHS, then it will be both circles are intersected orthogonally. Okay, C1, what is C1? Minus 11 plus 11 equals to 2 of G1. What is G1? 2, 1, 2 into minus 2 plus F1 is minus 1 and F2 is a minus 4. Okay, it becomes 0 equals to 2 times minus 4 and is minus into minus plus 4. So 0 equals to 2 times 0, 0 equals to 0. So we are getting LHS equals to RHS. Therefore, both are orthogonally. Circles intersects orthogonally. That means both circles are intersected in between the angle is 90 degrees. Find k if the circles x square plus y square plus 4x plus 8 equals 0 and x square plus y square minus 16y plus k equals 0 are orthogonally. That means already said both are orthogonally. That means here C1 plus C2 equals to 2 times G1, G2 plus F1, F2. This is equals because they are orthogonally. Orthogonal means the angle between the two circles is 90 degrees. So here C1. C1 equals to, we can write 8 plus K equals to 2 into G1. G1 is equals to 4. 4 means we can get 2. And G2 is not there here. That means the X term is not there. That's why it becomes 0. Plus F1. F1 is from this here, not there. So that means Y term is not given. So that it becomes 0. And F2 is equals to minus 8. 8 plus K equals to 2 times. 2 times 0 is a 0. Plus A, 0 times something is a 0. So finally it becomes 0. 8 plus k equals to 0 and k equals to, we can get minus 8. This is a k value when the both circles are orthogonally intersected. And next, find the equation of the radical axis of the circles x square plus y square minus 2x minus 4y minus 1 equals 0 and second circle x square plus y square minus 4x minus 6y plus 5 equals to 0. That means here S equals to, we can write first circle, x square plus y square minus 2x minus 4y minus 1 equals 0. And S dash equals to x square plus y square minus 4x minus 6y plus 5 equals to 0. Okay, to find radical axis or common tangent or common chord. Good. For all, we have a one formula, that is S minus S dash equals to 0. S minus S dash equals to 0 to find the common chord or common tangent or radical axis. Okay, here S, S is x square plus y square minus 2x minus 4y minus 1 equals 0, and S dash equals to this is. So we have to do subtraction. So x square minus x square. So let us write it first S. X square plus y square minus 2x minus 4y minus 1 equals, sorry, minus of S dash. S dash is what again? X square plus y square minus 4x minus 6y plus 5. Okay, first we have to change the x square plus y square minus 2x minus 4y minus 1. And here this become, here minus is there in front of bracket, so that all will be opposite sign. So it become minus x square, and it become minus y square, and this become, it become plus 4x, and it become plus 6y, and it is minus 5. Okay, here a plus x square minus x square gets cancelled, plus y square minus y square gets cancelled, and here minus 2x and here plus 4x is in right together, and here minus 4y and here plus 6y is there right together, y terms and constants also right together, and here minus 1 minus 5 equals to 0. Okay, when you take both 4x minus 2x, that become plus 2x, 6y minus 4y, that become plus 2y, and minus 5 minus 1 equals to minus 6 equals to 0. From all, we can take 2 as a common. So 2 of x plus y minus 3 equals to 0. So finally, we can get the equation of radical axis is equals to x plus y minus 3 equals to 0. And similarly, we can find this way, only same this way, we can find the common chord and common tangent of the given circles. Okay, if you like this video, please subscribe my channel and share to your friends. Thank you, friends.